next generation mobile computing product spotlight. Hi, I'm your host, Rose Diaz, and we'll be exploring all the greatest new mobile computing innovations as they unfold around the world. It's an exciting time for sure with the recent announcement by Apple and AT&T around the iPhone 3G, as well as Verizon's competitive offering by LG called the Dare. We wanted to take the Dare and see if it stacked up against the iPhone, which we've been using for the last few months. Both mobile phone computers are technology breakthroughs at the price point of around $200, but we thought we'd look at the features and how you would use these to help you decide which solution is right for you. What is it about these devices that would help make your job, life, or day-to-day existence better in some way versus crashing your car as you surf the internet? IM is the most used feature according to studies on phone behavior. But these aren't just phones with a small browser. They are an entire entertainment center, camera, personal organizer, internet browser, GPS, and more. We wanted to start with the basics of IM and then work down the features to give you a sense of the engineering that went into both of these phones. Let's say you're walking along the street listening to your favorite song and you feel the vibration of an incoming message on your IM. If you're an Apple iPhone user, you'd stop, open up your IM, and with a very intuitive interface, you'd reply to the message with the drop-down touch keypad and go back to your song once you're finished. The same incoming message on the Dare would not interrupt your song. You'd have the option of using the traditional phone-style keypad that you've honed your IM skills on over the years, or use the landscape full-size QWERTY keypad, or if you prefer using the handwriting recognition feature. You'd send your message back to your associate without missing a beat to your song. It may not seem like a big deal, but imagine standing in line for an event and IMing and rocking out to your heart's desire. I'd have to give the nod to the Dare in the area of true multitasking. Which brings us to the music rockdown. iTunes is built into the iPhone, which gives you the ability to store your music, purchase music and applications right from your iPhone. But Dare users can utilize any existing MP3 or purchase music the same way through VCast, albeit iTunes provides a richer interface. But outside of this factor, they both support up to 8 gigabytes of storage, and the iPhone has a 16 gigabyte version as well. The Dare utilizes an expansion SD card, which is a great way to expand your library. The docking station for the iPhone connects to the USB basically the same way as the Dare, which allows desktop syncing of all your mail, address book, and media files. I'd have to give the nod to the iPhone in this category. GPS, or graphical positioning system, is a feature that everyone will quickly find as a must-have for a mobile smartphone computer. The Dare gives both voice and text commands for directions, while the iPhone 3G only provides text. I believe the mapping functionality may be better on the iPhone, but it certainly is handy to be driving and listening to your route instead of looking at the 3-inch screen. I'd have to give the GPS battle to Dare. Taking quality photos and sharing them with your friends and family is a high priority for most users. The Dare upped the ante for Apple by providing a Schneider Krausnack lens with 2x zoom, reaching a resolution of 3.2 megapixels. Throw in a flash, and the dedicated camera features alone are worth over $120 on a standalone digital camera. But the key differentiation over a digital camera is the aspect of instant sharing with high-speed uploads to a blog site or email attachment off the phone. Imagine a realtor standing in front of the house they are going to sell, doing a complete walkthrough and sending the photos and/or videos to their own website for display on the MLS within minutes of the first visit. Or better yet, a collector who finds a rare item at an antique store and takes a photo of the item while standing there. He then creates an auction on his eBay store, finds out that his first bids are coming in a few hundred dollars ahead of the price being charged at the store. He goes back to the shop, makes a reasonable offer, and then walks off with a few hundred dollars in profit within a few minutes. All because of the immediacy of the phone camera high-speed internet combination. The world will change with higher resolution, sharing of images, and the Dare will be leading the charge. The engineers were thinking ahead when they incorporated a simple way way to take panoramic photos along with cropping, editing, and annotation tools to catalog photos. Next generation Apple iPhone applications should be improving upon the photo catalog that is currently shipping with the iPhone. The iPhone has an intuitive interface for taking photos, but falls way short of the dare in the photo feature battle. Ever since Apple's announcement of the iPhone application development kit, thousands of programmers have been working around the clock to start uploading their applications to the Apple iStore to make them available for download, which could change everything. We got a hint of some of these applications at the recent Apple Developer Conference in San Francisco. Apple has a robust developer architecture called Cocoa Touch, which incorporates an easy way to create consistent user interface experiences to other OS environments such as Symbian and Microsoft Mobile. But in the meantime, until the iPhone hardware is retooled, LG still holds a superior camera technology. Which brings us to the camcorder built into the Dare. Never before has a phone camcorder included the ability to create slow motion sequences with the high shutter speed. This in itself is usually a high-end camcorder feature. They created a unique cataloging and upload feature for video right into the software. This is way cool. And if you're into motion imagery capture, this is the way to go. Look out, YouTube. You haven't seen anything until millions of people start uploading motion imagery encounters from their dares. The world can only imagine the level of real-time events encountered by millions of people around the globe. The Dare touts face recognition, which is a curious feature for people like me who have a terrible time remembering names. What if my phone could actually save me from an embarrassing situation where I knew the face but couldn't remember the name of the person I was talking to? One of the most intriguing features lies in its potential to foster applications around photometry. An insulation expert could take a photo of a house with his Dare and calculate the areas of greatest heat loss. Or an esthetician could give the client a sense of where the greatest sun damage occurred. I believe we are scratching the surface to where this technology will go over the coming years. So without a doubt, socially, we are in our infancy as a human race as to where a 3.2 megapixel phone camera and video recording device will take us on a smartphone. The iPhone takes nice photos, but with the Dare's 2x zoom, higher pixel resolution, and video handling, we are sure to see a whole new genre of street-based content that will drive art, business, and personal uses for these technologies. Who knows? Your next husband or wife may be stashed away on your phone while standing in line at your favorite club this weekend. Just don't forget to get their IM account while taking their photo. We'll have more on this from our field reporter, Scott Vail, in our next episode, The Mobile Pickup Artist. When we answer the question, would women be more impressed with a Dare or an iPhone while standing at a bar? Coming up next, the Dare as a mobile internet browser versus the iPhone 3Gs. Stay tuned to episode 2 of Next Generation Mobile Computing. My name is Rose Diaz, and we have way more to tell you in our next episodes. Be sure to take our show on the road with your new smartphone as we continue to introduce you to application solutions, new accessories, services, and ways to expand your knowledge of this area. No matter what smartphone you buy, we'll have something for you to get more out of your phone. It should be a fun ride. Until next time, this has been Next Generation Mobile Computing's premiere episode.